Well, as you can tell, we're in Sweden now. Yes, of course, they have windmills too. Just give you a little bit of a panoramic. This is about 8 p.m. at night. The sun's still shining, and the country's big.
And luscious and green.
Luscious and green, I have been told.
Every field.
And every field is luscious and green and full of crops. Right, it's time to set up tent now. And we have this wonderful tent, really. No complaints. It's about 8:30 now. Found a little campsite right next to something I'm going to show you now. Da-da! Da-da, da-da, da-da. Who sneaked in behind the windmill? Okay, then.
Getting stuck in the doofadanger.
Okay, now the reason our hair's like this at the end of the day is because we've had a helmet on all day, so don't criticise. Now I've thought about changing this bike wheel, actually, this one here, for this one here. Mary reckons it might be a bit heavy, but it's only from a decent hole in it anyway. But there, just like that. See, everything's all set up. See, told you it was easy.
This is our second day of cycling here in Sweden. And the conditions are absolutely perfect. The land is flat as far as the eye can see. We're on the cycle road, and the other good thing is this is our first day of sunshine since Holland, so that's a real treat in itself. Everything smells beautiful, we're on nice quiet roads, very little traffic, and I doubt we're going to get conditions as good as this anywhere else. Everybody's got secrets.
We'll be heading down that road in a second, dirt road. Okay, this is Jans. He's from Sweden, and we're at his mud camp at the moment in the sort of east coast of Sweden. This is the view from where we're staying and where our campsite was. Night with a whole lot of people, and here we are, just ready to turn off, get a load of this little backyard. There's lots of little things happening, and the evil witch, oh, a little duck, and a very nice fence. Isn't that just truly Swedish?
This is what Sweden's all about. Beautiful lakes, trees, forests. Let's go and have a look. We'll go and have a look. Oh, go over and under on a little jetty here.
Been wanting to sit by the lake ever since we started off, but the access hasn't always been really good. And lo and behold, today, beautiful day cycling along, and here's the lake.
Wouldn't think this was Sweden, would you, with the old classic stone walls?
All the way. Another forest. Looking inside is covered in the walls of the forest and covered in green moss. We've found a Swedish friend at last, and here he is, very lovable too.
And his name's Galalalabo in Swedish.
And he's very taken to us.
On our way to Gotland Island. 4.5 hours. Well, believe it or not, this is the Baltic Sea. Over there we have, where are we now? This is Gotland Island, by the way. We're about 130 kilometers from Lithuania, Tallinn. 530 kilometers from St. Petersburg. And we've got Finland on one side, Sweden on the other. Very interesting. We're going to travel around this island tomorrow and do a bit of explorazione. Yes, and we've set up the tent right by the ocean here. It's a damn nice place, I must admit. And the mist, which was like very fine rain, has all subsided now. And so we've left with a glorious evening. It's about 9 o'clock at night now, and of course, as you know, high in the northern regions here, it's very light up until 11 o'clock at night. And there we are. Lovely, isn't it? So we'll watch the sunset and just relax and read the paper. Right, we're going along beside the old castle walls, fortress walls in Visby. This was put up in the 12th and 13th century, and it was a major Viking area of trading here in Gotland. This is one of these great old slings that are used to fire a shot into a castle, a big boulder that can sometimes break the walls. That's pulled down, it's loaded into a tray bucket, the sling is then let go with this weight and boof into the castle walls. This covers about 12 kilometers around the town of Visby. All the buildings are original, date back at least 2 or 3 centuries, and have been preserved by the United Nations as a World Heritage Site. One of the old medieval places. A couple of warships. There's eight warships in town. Well, more like patrol boats. So that's the end of Gotland. We're on our way back to the mainland now. And then we'll head up and around to Finland. Here's our ship coming in now, so we'll take off back to the mainland. Okay, we're here now.
in Stockholm, and we're just going to find somewhere to stay.
Mary's starving.
That's unusual. As usual. Now, let's have a look around Stockholm, and I think we're going to find a youth hostel. Give it a go anyway. Pretend we're under 26. And I think that's it over there. We'll be exploring this city because we've spent a long time getting here. This is the main harbour area, and it's what you'd consider a reasonable day by Scandinavian standards. Battery energy drink from Finland, and we're in Taku, or Turku, depending on which way you look at it. The river's pretty filthy, the town's not bad, nice people, and it's got a bit of a rotten old industrial area down the end there. We probably shouldn't be staying here, after all we're right next to a some sort of museum and offices, but see how close we are to the town. Pretty daring, really.
This is me old mate, the moose behind me. We're heading up to Tampere, which is 150 kilometres north of Turku, which is down on the southwest coast of Finland. We hope to find a moose, and not to be confused with
Tampax.
That's right. Yes. Okay. Thank you, Mary.
We've been warned about mozzies in Finland. This is Rob's leg, just dirty part of it. And this is within about 5 minutes. They are everywhere, and they are big. My leg is now called the killing fields of Finland. Look at that. Eating away, enjoying the day. There's nothing can beat the mozzie way.
It's time to start filming the proverbial log cabin, and there's one, the owners of the campsite we're staying at. Very rare that we can find a campsite, in fact. Not really a log cabin, but a little cabin that we're going to cook in tonight, right next to our tent.
We've arrived just a little bit east of Tampere, which is about nearly 200 kilometres north of Helsinki. We were cycling along in this through the forest and through a mud road for 10 kilometres, and we came across... We saw the lake in the distance, and this chap, we cruised down to the nearest to the lake as we could, thinking, oh my God, it's all forest, it's all rough, where on earth can we camp? Now this was proving to be a little bit of a problem. Came across this chap in the car, and he hopped out and said, oh, look, you can camp in this little hut. By the lake, if you like, and that was great. Look at that, isn't that idyllic?
In Jamzo, Finland, and there's the bloke over the river there who's taking guard and looking after things on our behalf while we camp close to people's houses again. And there's a woman on this side, you see. But very nice spot. We've managed to get some beer, and Marilou's having a bread roll. We've got the washing hanging out there, and we're all cosy.
I'll introduce you to Matty Kalsman, who has an interest here in booking holiday houses and cottages. He takes care of this whole area as far as winter and summer accommodation. And Matty, What's happening in this area, and what's it all about?
Oh, this is a holiday resort area. The winter is there. It's very important for us, mainly at the moment. But as you can see, the scenery here, it's also a very nice area in the summertime. And now it's happening all the time. They are making new golf courses, new houses, new cottages. So it's one of the best and main areas, holiday resort area in the southern Finland.
Oh, okay. And of course it's good in the summertime. They're building a golf course over there, and people can come here in the summertime and enjoy the lakes and even go swimming. It's quite warm in the lakes here. And so if they're building a cottage or a holiday home, they can use it in summer and winter.
Tako, the area to come for summer and winter activities in the middle of Finland, with just about all the attractions of Lapland, but without the giant mosquitoes. Huge capacity of chairlifts that means no queuing and a comfortable ride to the top. No snowmobiles allowed on this particular road, although there is 800 kilometers of snowmobile track. We're currently going down a ski track at the moment, and then we'll show you what it looks like in winter. This is rather steep and rather scary.
Brakes checked.
Have you had your brakes fixed lately?
I try to remember. Was it last week? How was it?
Summertime, looking up the main intermediate ski field.
There's the winter shot showing the ski fields right across the mountain.
And the proposed new world's largest ski jump area.
Holiday homes nestled behind the trees and right by the lakes.
We are going to be a cooking center in the whole Tokyo area. So it's going to 300 to 400.
Many interesting cottages. Real Finnish log cabins, all for rent, all year round. It's a lovely spot. This is Matty and Maria's Kalsman's converted water tower with conference room on the top and two levels of housing, rooms, etc. just below, with 151 steps to get in. Entering the town of Nilsia, we will take you up to the water tower and it's a village, it's now a town actually, of about 7,000 people. It's 450 kilometers north of Helsinki. So here we are. We'll have a look around here and we'll start at the bottom. Guys, keep an eye on the place. There are 151 steps that go amazingly up through the center concrete tower. Okay, we're finally at the top here. We're going to give you a little tour through this wonderful place. Right, coming through to one of the views. There's 57 windows that give you obviously 57 views. And this is one of them, of the town of Nilsia. Coming through to the one of the many bathrooms, and of course we get another view. Matty's office, it's a hive of activity. This is where he does some of the designs and drawings. He's a civil engineer, so he designed this conversion of the water tower. He's got pretty terrible view, as you can see, over the lakes and the forests. Right, we'll have a look around now into the kitchen area with all the latest appliances, of course. Big double door refrigerator up here, lovely lounge, and of course more views of more lakes in the distance. This crazy converted grand piano. There's a couch
complete with the lid. This is a hoist they use for lugging up pianos and television and other heavy appliances. It swings out right out here. It has to come an awful long way up to the top here. Here's another panoramic shot of the beautiful lakes and view in the distance. This is typical of Finland's scenery. It's really all trees and lakes, but it is serene. Right, we'll carry on here, and as we walk around, and we will head upstairs in a minute. That's going downstairs. Coming upstairs now to this fantastic conference area, which gets more utilized in the winter when people are on skiing holidays. They can combine that with their conference and meetings. All the audiovisual aids are here. Lovely warm display of curtains lines this lovely room. Just pour water over the hot stones and away we go. Just carry on. Looking very nice tonight.
Yes.
You can just keep talking in Finnish, really.
Sorry, Finnish.
Finnish.
No niin, okei, tässä nyt olemme ja nyt olemme menossa kohti konserttia esiintymään sinne esiintyminen taiteilijoina.
Joo.
Helsinki at the moment, not a very exciting city, and we'll try and get some shots of all the construction work that's going on. This is one of the highlights apparently, some grand old building. Yes, we've arrived in Estonia now. Now, this is a supermarket and it's called Pood. No, well actually a normal shop is called Pood. I think a supermarket's called Poo. They forget the D because it's such a big place. Oh, we'll take you in and we'll have a little look, shall we? We're just 30 kilometers south of Tallinn. This is riveting. What do you think? Here we are, yes. It's Estonian supermarket. This is great, we've now got out of Scandinavia, look at this. It's only 8.6, there's 13 of these Estonian krones to the dollar. 7.5 alcohol volume, Rock is 8, what's that, 5.3. That Finnish beer, Lapin culture from Lapland, so to speak, is 4.5. And that's the dearest beer they've got, and yet it's the weakest. This is a lovely little village here, and it's called Kahila in Estonia, south of Tallinn. We're on our way to Riga in Latvia, and we've got this bit of fast traffic behind me. I better get out of the way, as you can see. And lovely gentleman's cut a bit of firewood. Yes. Lovely little old village, eh? Look at that. It's See how lovely the roads are, and the rain's been pouring down as usual. This is called a Northern European winter. Ah, no, it's not.
They love making nests atop of poles and telegraph poles. And in the meantime, Mary's just knocking on that door to see if we can stay on these rather idyllic Estonian backyard.
Well, we're very close to Panu, which is on the southwest coast. We've been cycling through this country and it looks like it's very run down and needs a lot of work done on it. The building behind me is typical of this, and where all the windows are smashed, it was some sort of ex plant of some sort. And over there is, in the background, is an apartment building which is terribly run down. It looks very much as though they've run out of money. The place is full of larders and Russian trucks, which I'll show you soon. And there's these small towns. This one's called Sini, which is just another example of being very run down. However, compensates beautifully by cheap prices. Okay, Tallinn's up that way, and Riga, which is 176 kilometers down that way. So we'll go to Riga now, Latvia.
It's not only a pub with no beer, but something's happened to it. This is probably typical of Estonia, where everything's sort of dismantled and smashed up and rotten. It's modern cars, as you'll see. Some classic larders, of course. So this is the Riga motorway. That's what that says, by the way.
All right, Latvia. Now, what can I say? We've been here a couple of hours, gone through the border guards, not particularly exciting. They want your passports, you go through Estonia, they want your passports, you start getting into Latvia, they want your passports as well. Anyway, not quite a nice place this. It's out the back of a little town just on the border. And of course, there we are, we're all set up. Isn't that nice?
Mary's gone to sleep. This is camping, Latvia style. Now these are all little cabins, and we're about 70 kilometers just north of Riga. And isn't this just phenomenal? They're not toilets over there. They're just vacant places. And this is our little paradise. $4 US a night, which is, no, $8 US a night. No toilet. I still can't find out with this campsite where the toilets are. Now there's this lovely musty smell in this place. Whoops, as he falls over the step. And just get a load of this bed. Latvia, the place for your summer holiday. Family groups and friends and ships taking wood.
Riga! Here we are, Latvia. It's the place you want to be. It's nothing like this 5 years ago. We're in a hotel that you want to believe. I'm going to show you a shot of the way the brochure says it, and then I'm going to show you a shot of the way it actually is. It's all corroded, the paint's coming off. Here we are, there's another shot here, and the metal works. All rusty, and if I don't want to lean on that too much because it might sort of fall over.
God knows what that is, but it's got three stars on it. I think that's something from the communist days where they had so much lack of flair, it was unbelievable. Awesome bridge, very new, but it's only got one pillar and the rest is held up by wires. That's the roof of the bar and the nightclubs, and you wouldn't want to spend too much time there. It's incredibly dilapidated. Look at this entrance. Sunset in Riga. Beautiful old building there. Trams, they're everywhere. They're from the Soviet era, and they certainly look like they're totally dilapidated like the buses, but we'll show you more of that later. This is the room as they advertised it on the brochure. This is the room as we got it. Sort of different, isn't it? If you can, and we're all set up here, of course. Whiskey, of course. Hang on, let's have a look. Alexander's Whiskey of Latvia. Only $7 US for 700 ml and it's 40%. So there's the front label. I was showing you the back label before. From the old to the new. This is Riga going through a rebirth after what you could call an afterbirth of destruction. The hotel where you're staying, it's a bit tacky, but the people were really nice and very helpful and friendly. Some of these roads never seem to end. Here we are, 35 kilometers out of Riga, Latvia, 35 degrees today. Very hot.
Very windy.
Headwind. And look where we have to go. Another 20 kilometers. It's late in the afternoon. This is a Latvian rail yard. They make passenger trains. I think what they do is they refurbish trains and send them to other old Russian state countries. Preparing for the day's cycling. Just approaching the Lithuanian border now, leaving Latvia. After a long straight road for most of the day, and there is the border at the end there. We're all the trucks lined up there, and we stop and get our passports out and get grilled as usual.
Lithuanians love their signs. This is a place called Sia.
Here comes Mary. Late, about 7 o'clock at night, and she's very tired, not feeling very well, and understandably so. This is about the most lively thing about this town called Šiauliai in Lithuania, is the fairly artistic graffiti on the walls in this outdoor amphitheater. And this being the stage, I just discovered this morning. It's not bad. Downtown Šiauliai, Lithuania today. Not the capital. It's about the third largest city in Lithuania. Good old communist housing estates. There are millions of them. Very drab, dry, nothing gets maintained, and forget about painting anything because it won't happen. Lots of wasted space everywhere you can see. Lithuanian garden, met some people who took us back for lunch at their place, and they have everything here. Okay, this is where they keep all the chickens, and they're very healthy.
This is on the tree.
And they are laying eggs all the time. Say that again, which one's which?
That is Mayo.
Mayo. Yeah. And okay, and we'll go up here. What have we got here?
It's very friendly.
Ah, yes.
Very nice.
And they're milking these goats all the time.
Yes.
For good goat's milk, which we had for lunch.
But people don't get any subsidies to help here, either in farmers.
This is a genuine witch's broom here. And very functional.
This sort of display is quite unique to Lithuania, and you see it done with different flowers, like lilies and all sorts of flowers, and it's just really, really beautiful. Looks very good. Thank you.
Gražus plūdas. Man pažįstė važinėti dviračiai. Ne, nenoriu. Geriau čia pabūkim. My name is David.
Where do you come from?
I come there in my grand.
Yes. Where do you live, David?
I live in Kaunas, in Lithuania.
Ah, yes. What country is that?
It is Arugula.
Ah, no. Your country, where you come from, is
Lithuania.
Uh-huh. Okay. And you introduce your friend now?
Yes.
Say?
Yes.
Okay. It's party time in Lithuania. Saturday night, 26th of July, 1998. And everybody's dressed up, including the child in the wheelchair. There are happy people, like all the people in the Baltics, I feel. When people aren't rich, they enjoy life better. I think the poorest countries we've been to have the happiest people. And they're good fun, and they want to know us, and we want to know them.
We call this a bit of a sight for sore eyes. This is Kaunas, which is the large city in Lithuania. You'll notice all those communist style apartment buildings that just go along the...
Thomas Angelus, MC and CD at the Musikos Albanas. Some shots of the old town of Kaunas. Good old Soviet telephone, still with the original phone in it. Let's go and have a look now. Isn't that a classic? Shows design and flair straight from the Soviet Union.
Josh.
Main promenade, Liberty Boulevard. Great beer. Great promenade. Very well dressed people. That looks like a bus I'm familiar with. Yes, coming down.
These statues behind me are all along the roadside. They are all, some of them are decorated with ribbons, all of them with flowers, some Jesus and some are of Mary. They're actually quite spectacular in their own way.
We're here in London, of course. Come over here to sort out a few medical things like teeth problems and bike problems, broken wheels and so on. And of course, to spend much more than we would like. London is incredibly expensive. And we're going through about five times our budget per day, which is a damn shame. We're heading back to Warsaw very shortly, however. We're in a couple of days. In the meantime, we've had the bikes fixed up, we've bought some bike bags, we've living in incredible heat at the moment. This is Hogarth Street with lots of Indian and Thai restaurants down the end there, with Earls Court Station at the end of this Hogarth Road. Alright, we're leaving London now, 7 o'clock in the morning. Lovely, beautiful day, going back to Poland, Warsaw. Should be there this afternoon, put the bikes together and out into the country and off down to Slovakia. Having just arrived at Warsaw Airport, now got to put the bikes together. And these are the bags they come in. Been quite a bit of damage around the brand new bags. Warsaw Airport people just threw them down.
Yes, Luna Parki, or sea or something. Quite interesting, isn't it, the wording? Europa. Hey, Luna Park, Warsaw. Not a lot of people. Then again, not a lot of people with a lot of money. But this is quite interesting. Crazy ghost train.
Yeah, it's nice to be out in the countryside again, in the middle of Poland, about 90 kilometers south of Warsaw now. A little old town called Lobby.
Now, this just gives you an idea. Supermarkets, little shop in behind there, another supermarket. Not a lot to see in these little towns, I suppose. This is another storefront. Notice the abundance of advertising in this dairy. Many of these Catholic monuments, Jesus or Virgin Mary, and of course many Catholic church. Mary playing with some Polish kids in a park.
We're 85 kilometres east of Radom, and we camped out in a farmer's field last night. We're having excellent weather. We just stopped at this little spot because it's just a lovely surroundings. We've just cycled through a lovely little part of bush to a valley this morning. This river here goes through Warsaw. It's a big river. And they're having some sort of promotion to the left of us.
Polish town, very typical of them all. Very hard to film and ride the bike at the same time.
Good. Yeah, I like it. Come in.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's
and party.
Party in here, a little party sometimes?
Sometimes.
Yeah. We're going to have a look at the turkeys now. Mm-hmm. In the backyard.
Dog. Mookie. Big dog.
There's a big one here. There's about 50 turkeys, I think.
These turkeys here, they are called the Mafia.
Oh.
32.
32.
Mm-hmm. All right.
32, yeah.
And chickens? How many hens?
15, 16. Dobrze, tak jak tatuś chyba mówił, tak to było.
Że co?
Że tych kur.
Kur? Mm-hmm. 60.
60.
O tych.
16.
Tak.
16.
Bryłka.
At Christmas time, Christmas, turkeys,
to tierken.
Yes, mm-hmm. Yeah, and mm-hmm. eat.
Yes,
then.
Yes.
So they. And this is
Moki
is 4 months old, so he's just a pup, right?
Okay.
It's beautiful dog.
Yes.
Here's the chief just arrived. You're in Salalava. Bit of a rainy day, and we've taken a day off to enjoy this wonderful site of Soviet-designed apartment blocks. Lovely style. Oh, very considerate. Someone grows a vine at the bottom and lets it grow all the way up. Makes the place look a bit more attractive. Let's have a look into some of these apartments. Of course, never complete without your good old muddy patch outside. Got some pretty nice cars around.
This is your classic Polish house, little run down, but I'm sure a little improved. The Carpathian Mountains. We talked about coming to the Carpathian Mountains. Well, this is just the beginning of them, and as you can see, there's an awfully big valley down there, and there was an awfully long, steep road coming up here.
It's very windy.
And it's very windy, extremely windy, horrible day. But we've got a long way to go yet. 24 kilometers from the Slovakian border.
We're down in a valley here now in Poland, 10 kilometers from Slovakia. And I just want to show you an example of the sort of houses that are going up all over Poland. They're all in the region of 3 to 4 story houses. Some of them actually quite posh.
Slovakian border, at last, after quite a few hills. Doesn't look too lethal, that one. Looks quite tame. Bit of a queue, but we'll probably just sail right through it.
We've just got into Slovakia. We've had 5 kilometers downhill, just no brakes on, superb. Makes up for the other few days climbing up. And it's very luscious here. It's a beautiful and warm, lots of things to look at, and at the back of us here is a beautiful church with a lovely dome. It promises to be very exciting.
This depicts the spot in Kaposova, Slovakia, where the Russians won a tank battle against the Germans. The Russian tank, of course, is the one, the green one up there with the star, and of course we all know the German one is the one with the black cross.
We'll go Very well depicted, I thought.
Yeah, we'll go and have a little look at that on this lovely day in Slovakia. Oh, this is on the quite a large lake actually, and like most things in Central Eastern Europe, pretty run down. We'll go and have a look around. It's a beautiful lake, about 100 kilometres south of Polish border. Now these are interesting. Everywhere throughout Slovakia they have these horns in trucks, and these blast out announcements, probably from the Soviet days. This is a small town, and this is an indication of the style of housing. This is what greets us as soon as we enter Hungary. About 100 kilometres south of Slovakia. Stayed in a funny old town for a couple of days. We're off now, feeling fit and healthy. A lot of railways, crossings, small roads, some very derelict towns. Okay, we're here at this Hungarian restaurant. We've got to try some Hungarian food before we leave this country. So we're going to show you a little picture of what they say we're going to get, and which they're very clever in taking photographs of it. And then we're going to compare that with the real thing. So we'll go into the restaurant and have a look.
Okay, now this one, I'll get a close-up of this.
Okay, we don't know what it's called. We can see the writing there. We've asked the man on the menu to give us one of these. So that's one. We probably look like stuffed cabbage or something. And we've ordered one of these as well. And that's called a something or other. And then some pancakes for afterwards.
Okay, and this is what we got. Notice it's missing the rice and the garnishing and the cucumber. So we've mixed it all up, included the cabbage, which also didn't have the garnishing. But it's quite a nice meal. Harry's enjoying
it. Especially when you're hungry.
Growing, well, growing the potatoes. And now they're picking them. And they're hungry, but we're quite impressed at how mechanized they were. Hey, genuine Hungarian restaurant with thatched roof. We found the oasis and we're walking around it now. This is the Hungarian oasis.
And it's a perfect day.
And look at this beautiful pond. And we're going to take you to over 10,000 square meters of thermal pools. Now this is a trabant. Now this is what probably the most successful thing that ever came out of East Germany. Just look at this amazing vehicle, would you? Isn't that just state of the art? And the upholstery is just looks beautiful with a rear end that would make any Japanese car manufacturer envious. That's the neatest colony over there, and can't quite see anything at the moment, but we'll probably pop over there later. We're going to go in this very soon. 28 to 34 degrees, that sounds like us. And Mary's getting all ready for the hydro slide. These are called Tasfolis Centos, 150 Hungarian florins.
This is Hungarian food, about 350 florins here. And just looking at the food at the moment, the man next to me thinks I'm looking at him, but in actual fact, I've found the map Blake would have been looking for and the world.
Okay, this is the wave pool. To compensate for the fact that they're 1,000 kilometres from the nearest sea, and it's a huge pool, everybody's swarming in. Watch them all go. We call this the seal colony.
We're at a very special dinner at the moment, and we've been invited into this hotel. These are all our friends. Hungarian people, very hospitable. And Rita over the back there.
We're having
beautiful food.
Yes, goat goulash and beef goulash. And it's very nice.
Some pasta.
Here's Mary coming into what we call Romania.
Okay, here we are in Romania. Just gone through a thunderstorm.
You'll see the distances to all these places that we're going to behind us. And we're just coming into the city of Arid, and I think it will be pretty arid. We've seen some pretty slummy places already in Romania, and we've only done about 90 kilometers. So we'll show you more.
Today we've come from Arid. It's quite a big city actually. The roads are chronically busy. The drivers are absolute maniacs.
Stunning castle on the hill. This is the town of Diva. The stunning castle ruin makes way for the stunning architecture. You don't knock it, there's a lot of thought went into this. Look, they made two identical ones.
Staying in this Romanian villa, about 50 kilometers east of Diva, that wonderful place. Tomatoes, cabbages, pears type peaches, and grapes. Grapes. Very well here. The ancient town of Brasov, central Romania.
We're surrounded by the mountains here, and we're in the old part of the city. They've made it into a very nice square, and they've actually done quite a bit of work on this. We've just been to a beautiful, amazing, I must say, old church called the Black Church, which goes back to 1211. Now this city here was completely surrounded by walls, like castle walls, in the 14th century. You could only get in and out through through archway doors, a bit like Medina's.
Blustery day, we've arrived at Dracula's castle, Castello Bran, in the Romanian Transylvanian Alps.
And we've been looking forward to getting here.
We have indeed, but it's just the right Dracula day today, so we're going to go through the castle and have a look. It's a great big place.
Okay, we're at Hotel Palesh.
Yes.
Radu, tell us about the castle. What?
Ah, I tell you about it. The castle is founded from 80 years ago. It's a nice construction because it's construction from the architect, the Austrian architect. And inside in a castle is 260, 270 rooms. And now it's possible visiting just 30, 35 rooms.
This is King Carol's palace. This is where the king lived. Of course, there's no king in Romania now. Beautiful grounds. High in the Transylvanian mountains.
Everything, but the guide and translator give everything.
Oh, we've arrived at Constanța, Romania, on the Black Sea coast. I can see now why they call it the Black Sea coast. It's probably got more pollution than any other sea in the world, thanks to the Soviet way of doing things. We're going to head down into Bulgaria now, Varna and Burgas and then Istanbul. As you can see, the architecture here is just quite stunning. This is a round building, but like everything, it's not really very well looked after. It's a busy, really busy city, this one.
Extremely grotty. Rubbish absolutely everywhere.
Yeah. That's for sure.
Not a pleasant place to
be. But it's a beautiful day, so we'll head off now.
Six city, yeah?
All right, here.
Istanbul now. It's unbelievably chaotic. We're now in the Sultanahmet, which is quite a touristy area. There's lots of treasures here. Behind us is the Blue Mosque, and we've just been in there now. It's just huge, big dome building, beautifully crafted, and it's for a place of prayer. And then, to the back of us, more excitement is the pink something or other.
Saint Sophie.
Progress all the time, you know, but I'm busy coming. Progress all the time, you know, but I'm busy coming.
Turkey, we've left Istanbul and come around the coast and we're heading to a town called Erdek. Hope to have a few days off here, get a pension and spend a few days by the beach with the cloud stow away, that is. And so we'll see how we go.
In Erdek, beautiful setting, and we're going down for a swim very soon. And we've got the city of Erdek at the other end of the beach. Just over there.
Decided to take a bit of a holiday, so we came along to this resort, mainly for the local Turkish people, to Erdek, and staying in this hotel here for 10 days or so. It's quite good weather. It's been raining a little bit, but today it's just beautiful. So I'm going to go in for a swim any minute now. This place is just absolutely riddled with hotels all along the seafront, the whole way along.
Looking out from the hotel we're at, Mary's having a drink at the moment, and it's a beautiful night. And it's been a beautiful day.
Very presentable, very, very delicious. Lots of, this is a stuffed pepper, lovely fresh salads, eggplant with sour cream.
Very presentable. So. Yes, we love these cobblestones. And we love the dirt and grime.
Give me the key!